as the couponers ready themselves at the starting line.
3, 2, 1, coupon!
Right off the bat, both couponers dash across the aisles, aiming for items farthest from the register. For Antoinette, this means grabbing a variety of items in the meat department.
Excuse me, I need 28.
So the hot dog, the retail price is $1.99 a package. They were on sale for 99 cents, and a coupon for 75 cents off two, making them 61 cents.
Uh-oh, some of those are singles, and those are not on sale.
So I had to put those back and then recount everything.
While Antoinette loses valuable time double-checking her quantity of hot dogs, Judy gets busy raking in some unbeatable deals on drink mixes.
Oh my goodness, chocolate drink mix. I am getting all of the ones they have.
The chocolate drink mix is usually $1.50 per packet, on sale for 99 cents, then a coupon for 60 cents. Doubles to $1.20, which is more than the price of the product. So free.
19. I'm not really a shelf clearer, but you know what? There's exceptions to every rule.
Antoinette turns the aisle, hoping to surge ahead with a coupon for free potatoes. But a loss of direction shatters her steady pace.
I'm looking for these mashed potatoes.
I constantly kept looking for these mashed potatoes.
Oh, that's not it either.
And I could not find them.
Antoinette, are you there? Let's go, let's go. You got it, you got it.
I hope I don't get in trouble for that.
I'm tired.
Meanwhile, Judy has already gathered 9 of the competition's 15-item minimum.
One bag of candy.
Oh, let's go.
As Frank sounds the alarm that she's reached the 20-minute mark.
So that's 10 minutes.
Still struggling with her list.
Where is these mashed potatoes?
Antoinette makes a bold move to skip the potatoes. Instead, she cashes in on boxes of tea that retail for $2.59. But combining the $1.50 sale price with her dollar coupons, they will cost Antoinette just 50 cents each.
2, 3.
She snatches 6 boxes of sale price pasta and then reaches towards a top shelf loaded with cat treats.
So the top shelf, the curse of the top shelf, all short people need to have someone who could go grocery shopping with them. Have to stand on top of cat treats and cat boxes in order to get stuff off the top of the shelf.
Rather than veer out of order herself, Judy stays the course on a carefully plotted store map. This ensures she'll grab products near one another without repeating aisles.
Sponges, aisle 11. Aisle 11. 6, 7, 8. And then I need, oh yeah, some soap. Let me just make a mark so I know. Cat treats. Yes, I love when I can get more than one thing in the aisle.
The missing potatoes throw Antoinette off her game plan, but she still managed to fill a cart with 10 of the competition's 15 item minimum and is ready to grab even more.
Okay, I'm gonna get another cart because this heavy. I need a cart.
You need a cart? Okay.
Which aisle is the mashed potatoes?
Mashed potatoes, I think it was aisle 4. Check aisle 4.
Oh, mashed potatoes, I see them.
With a fresh card and renewed direction from Danielle, Antoinette charges back into the aisles.
Go, Antoinette, go, go, go.
Antoinette rushes over to the pet care aisle, where a deal with potential overage could give her the advantage in this competition.
Zark food was the regular price $7.99, and I applied a $4 coupon. When I scouted the store, it was priced at $2.99, so it would have gave me my overage.
Combining her $4 coupon with a $2.99 sale price would give Antoinette a $1.01 overage. Unfortunately for Antoinette, the sale is over. Rather than earning an overage, she stands to pay $3.99 per box.
Nah, man, this goes against everything a couponer does.
Meanwhile, Judy is ready for her pre-ordered item, 64 bottles of soda. But to claim them, she must first track down a store clerk.
Do you work here?
No, I don't, I'm sorry.
No problem. Oops, I'm sorry. Do you know where somebody is that could help me with the soda order I placed? No? It's okay, I'll find someone. Oh my goodness, do you know where my soda is? Can you just bring it up front for me?
Yeah.
Awesome, sweet, thank you.
Antoinette, you're coming up on 10 minutes. 10 minutes left.
Antoinette has no trouble finding help for her own pre-order of 50 bottles of soda.
I'm sorry, I pre-ordered pop. Do you know who I could get the pop from?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I should run while she's doing that. Let's go, Antoinette, you got it, you got it.
Call Madison. Man, what the world?
Where'd the lady go?
Excuse me, sorry.
Oh,
Ew. It's heavy. Danielle?
Where's she at? Let's see.
Pushing the cart up to the register slows Antoinette's pace as she nears the 9-minute mark.
I got 50.
Let's go, hon.
But Judy's already at the end of her list, or so she thinks. She scoops up pizzas in the frozen food aisle and heads to the register for a final check of all her quantities.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the other juice drinks. I got 2 of the waffles.
21 minutes.
Oh, I didn't get
seconds.
That, so I can't use that. I thought, hey, I'm all set and I'm ready to stop the clock. And I'm like, oh my goodness. What about the hot sauce? Oh, you know what? I didn't get this.
Yeah,
thank
go get the hot
God.
Sauce.
Oh my goodness. Oops. Sorry, excuse me.
Okay.
Holy mackerel, don't fall. That would be bad. The smaller size bottle was $1.39. I had a 75 cent off coupon, which doubled to $1.50 off, so that was free.
7, 8, 15. Oh my goodness, they almost rolled out.
I love it. Okay.
Sprinting back to the register, Judy takes one final pass through her cards.
12 drops of pizzas and my sponges and my partridge in a pantry. And is that everything? Is it possible?
47.
That is everything. Time.
4 minutes and 7 seconds left.
No!
What did you forget?
Seconds are ticking away, but Antoinette still has more to grab and isn't quite sure if she's hit the $500 minimum yet. If she falls short, she will be disqualified.
30 seconds, Antoinette, 30 seconds.
7, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Her list isn't done, but time is up, meaning Antoinette cannot add any additional items to the carts she's already brought up to the register.
So we're like halfway there. Looks like I have quite a few coupons left. And 103. 101. And the next number is, yes, can I say, $99.87.
Nice. Woo! Very nice.
As the cashier reaches the last of the coupons, another glitch in the register jeopardizes Judy's totals.
Oh, no.
No.
Yeah, they're not scanning.
I think somebody sabotaged this machine.
The way it started with the manual entering the coupons, it seems like it's going to end that way.
Last coupon.
Yay.
Final total after coupons is $24.11.
Yay!
That's a 95.9% savings percentage. Judy's best ever. But will it be enough to defeat her rival, Antoinette?
I want to win. There's no joke. I'm not going to say I just came to play and blah, blah, blah.
I hope I really beat her butt. That will make me so happy.
We're about to do the second transaction. The first one was $358.
Antoinette hopes to finish strong with a high savings percentage, but quickly realizes she has more to worry about. If this transaction does not surpass $142, Antoinette's combined total will be less than $500, and she will be disqualified from the competition.
It's not over yet.
Oh no!
Crap, Ola. $89.73.
We can break 500.
The combined total of Antoinette's transactions comes to just $448.53, just short of the $500 minimum and eliminating her from the competition.
Oh. I'm lost for words.
Coupons lower her second transaction to $45.28, but Antoinette is off her game, mustering just a 72% savings and a disqualification that solidifies Judy's victory.
I just got one thing to say. Sister Say a Lot, you've been couponated.
Oh. I might not have won the competition. However, families still get the benefit. Everything goes to charity, so I'm happy about that.